Okay, yeah, second. That's yes.
Fine. Yeah, good afternoon. Yes, we are going to start from where we stopped last time. And maybe I'll give you a recap of what we did last time. We did a rigid body motion, and we looked at the transformation between different cone systems. And here we have an example where we are training a point one with reference to coordinate system B. And in the right, a generalized equation where we are finding the same point with respect to a different coordinate system A. And we went step by step, and we arrived at this generalized equation on how to define a point from one coordinate system to a different coordinate system. So I want us now to extend on this. And maybe before we elaborate further, this transformation here was defining the point or the position. Then this one was defining the orientation of coordinate system A, B, with respect to A, coordinate system A. So I want us to expand this same expression in what we call 4x4 transformation matrix. Because most of the transformation you're going to do in robotics will be expressed in terms of 4x4 matrices. And in most books or in some books, this transformation is referred to as homogeneous transformation. And how do we go about expanding this equation to a 4x4 homogeneous? So these ones are expressed as 4x4 matrix as follows. The same point we have this matrix here. Yeah? Then you have this one here. Then we have this point. So for homogeneous, we just expand this one and we have a 4x4 matrix. So we have one there. So for this matrix here, we have that 3 zeros, then 1. So as you can see here, this one is a 3x3 matrix. If you expand by this, you have a 4x4, a 4x4 matrix. So this one can be given this notation, transformation. The transformation or the wholesale transformation that will determine the position and orientation of point one with respect to coordinate system A. So we can have B A for this matrix so that the final point can be written in terms of this matrix B times now this point here. So B
what this matrix contains.
Do an example before we proceed on. So I'll give you an example. Well, you have a coordinate system, eh? Then you have another coordinate system. Okay. Like that. Then you have a point expressed in terms of this coordinate system. So the problem is formulated as follows. So initially, the A coordinate system and B coordinate system are assumed to be coincident. Then this coordinate system B is rotated 30 degrees about Z axis. Then you are told it's also translated. Then if we can first of all find this matrix, to evaluate this matrix, we have a rotation matrix. You have 0, 0, 0. Then you have 1. So for this, we are translating 10 units along x-axis. So you have 10. Then 5 units along y axis, 0, 1. So this is for this problem. Then for orientation, this matrix here, for orientation, I'm just going to state it first, then later, we are going to look, or we are going, I'm going to show you how you do the presentation of that matrix.
Please, doctor. This zero in the coordinate that you have just written, is it for Z?
Yeah, this is it. Okay. So we have X, we have Y, we have Z. Because Z, you are not making translation. So for this one, rotation by 30 degrees about Z axis. We have this one represented as 0.866. We have 0.50, 0,
We have 0.000, 0, and then we have 0.5, 0, 0, 0.866, 0, 0, 0. Then we have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Yeah, like this. So this one is this matrix. No. Ah, right now. Right. So if now you are required now to express a certain point, and in this case, that point, point B. Given as 3, 7, 0, like that. So we express this point now with respect to this coordinate system. We are required now to expand this matrix in this form, then we apply that point here. So we need to expand this. We have 0.866, negative 0.5, 0.5, 0.866, 0, 0. 0, 0. We have 0. Sorry, 0 should be 30. I believe by 3 by 3 matches. 3 by 3 matches. So we have 0, 1. So this is the first matrix. Then you have this other one. 10 squared 0. 10, 5, 0. So we are saying if we want to write it in continuous, we have there as 1, there, we have 0 there, 0, 0, 1. Like that. Then you can have point B. And you can have B is point A. Is you multiply 3, 7 0. Do that. You have the final equation or the result for that given as 9.098 12.562, and we have 0.00, and we have the final answer. And that's confirmed whether this one is the correct answer. You have a question? Before we proceed on to the next. Any question?
The BP equals
zero.
Zero. Yeah.
This is like this point here. So we I've just given an arbitrary. These are the coordinate system from this point.
But why do we need that point in order to?
Sorry?
Why do we need that point?
So what you're doing, yeah? We are looking at the transformation. These are basic for robotics, yeah? So we are doing a rigid motion, yeah? As a
as an introduction to robotic manipulation. Right? So here we are just looking at the point. Then later we are going out to extend this knowledge now inwards and not forward and inwards can matter for the robot. Right? So just for the completeness of the of this class, so we have seen this transformation, and we did the derivation, right? But there are other instances whereby you are required now to do the inverse of this, right? So I'm just going to give you an expression of how you get the inverse of this without doing the derivation, right? So the inverse of this is given by V, A. Which is a really expressed as follows. Now, if that's what the original matrix is, T here stands for transpose. So, 0, 0, 0. You have negative B R transpose. So we need the expression for the inverse of this matrix. So I have expressed in terms of the same thing of the original matrices. For rotation, we are taking the transpose, right? Then in minus, we take the transpose of this other matrix, multiply by this other one. Then you expand it to have a 4x4 matrix. So you just looked at one point. Eh? Oh, sorry, if you looked at one point in two-point system, right? So I want us now to look at a scenario where you have a point but defined in more than one point system, right? So we are going to look at the compound transformation. So we have, or we start with the coordinate system, eh? So we move to another coordinate system. So this is B.
another one. See? So, I'm looking at a point here, point one. That is in this consistency. So this is C. Now, can we get a generalized expression where you are going to express this point one with reference to the coordinate system N? So this is the so, for this one, we know this. We know point one, or we are assuming that we know this point. One, with respect to this coordinate system. And this one can be expressed by this transformation, B, C, then we have P, 1, C. Like what you had previously for two coordinate system. Right? Then you can obtain the final answer. As follows. Now the same point, instead of now this coordinate system, D. You have it in terms of A. You have this transformation A, B, C, and you have B, and that. But you already know this. You already know this. By this one. So we can have this one in nearby. Then instead of just this, we can start this. Then the final point C, like that. So here we have the transformation matrix from B to A, then from B to C, yeah, explained by these two transformations. Then we multiply by this final point to get the overall transformation of that point. Any question before we go to the standard? How we derive the standard transformation matrix. Then is standard transformation. And this is how you go about it. We have two So we have ZA. So we start with the first one. I think rotation. I think my theta. The actually is about. So we assume two coordinate system. Here you have A. Then you have another one B that are hoisted, but rotate So we are initially assuming they are constant, right? But now we are rotating now the B coordinate system by alpha about x axis, right? So if you do that, you can have this projection. So you have 1, 0, 0. We don't have any rotation about any. We don't have any angular displacement. Yeah. On this, eh? So the other now this one. This one will be given by 0 cosine. Say. This one, yeah. This one is sine, and this one here is cosine. Then we come to this one, the projection here. Yeah. Z. This one will be 0 about x axis. Then you have here this one there. Negative sine. Sit cosine. Now it comes to negative sine cosine. So that now that rotation, x axis about by alpha will be given by this one, this one, this one. Right? So we have 1, 0, 0. We have 0 cosine. Then you have this one 0, negative sine, cos. So this is the standard transformation matrix of rotation about x axis. Yeah? So you do the same for y-axis and z-axis, and result this is the first matrix. So the second one Then last but not least, now that I've listened about the dances by Ghana. So the dances by Ghana. It's given by course. I said when you're doing the transformation or the manipulation of the robot, right? You like them in a thousand linear matrices. Eh? For instance, in that question, in that problem, in this problem, where I give these matrices, 0.886. 0.5, 0, 0, -5.00, 0.866, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 and 0. We have 0 from the left end. We have 5, 0, 1. We have this equation somewhere. And we see this one. We determine the orientation. And this equation, if you check here now from the standard transformation. Yeah. If you check from standard transformation, you can tell that this equation is corresponding to this one. Huh? Because we are rotating that degree is about
z axis.
Yeah? So if you do quick substitution with 30 degrees, you'll be able now to see cos 30 is 0.866, right? Then sin 30 is 0.5. No, this one should be 0.5. Right there. And again, we are expanding this one. This way, we just write it in a form of homogeneous. We have 4 by 4 matrix. So the standard matrix, we are 3 by 3. Yeah? So we do this extension to represent them in the form of homogeneous matrix. Right? Yeah, of course. If no question. I'll give you another example. I'll give you another example where you have
application of compound transformation. So the problem is with this example. So here the coordinate system A and B are initially then B is translated to this coordinate system. Then rotate it. That it is about x axis. Then rotated 60 degrees about an axis that passes through point measure the current coordinate system. It is parallel. So you are required of finding new transformation. How do we go about that? So the first transformation matrix is for this transition. It's given by 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0. Then you have 5 4 1 1. So the second transformation. Will be given now by the rotation about that degrees about x axis. So we have 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 cos 30. Second transformation. So the third transformation. The third transformation is this one. So what will happen before we do the rotation, we'll be able now to do this transformation. Then after rotation, we reverse it back. So the third. So we'll be given 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then you have 2, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 1. After that, we go to the fourth. To the fourth transformation, this one, rotation of 60 degrees about y-axis. That's B. So the third or the fourth transformation will give my T T given by cos 60 0 negative sin 60 0 0 1 0 0 sin 60 degrees 0 cos 60 0 0 0 1. Then finally, we pass this transformation, the final one. So we have F B. We will give it 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then you have -2, 0, -2, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then to get now the overall transformation, you have B related to A. We will be given by A C B. Then you have D E. Then you have